Hello everyone. Let's see how to configure M251 DPAC I/O modules and faceplates. Open the System tab and go to Logical Devices. Here, double-click on the device M251. Double-click to open the resource, and click on the Hardware Configuration tab. Here is a little tip. You can also right-click on the device M251 and select Open Hardware Configurator. By clicking on the Add New Master button, you can add the bus TM3. Right-click on the bus and select Add to choose the I/O modules. Click on the Stay box to keep the pop-up opened. Be careful. Make sure that you first add the CPU M251 and then add the I/O modules in the same order that they are physically connected. Then open the Symbolic Links tab. Drag and drop the inputs and outputs of your application and save. Focus point. You need to add the function block dpac_full_init inside the resource of your device for a software and hardware initialization. Let's create a new canvas for maintenance purpose, for example. Open the node Canvases, right-click, and select New Item. Enter the name of your canvas and click on Finish. Here you can find the cat instances of the hardware modules you just created. Drag and drop the CPU M251 representation, then the input and output modules. You can also use another faceplate representation like this. Finally, you can test this new canvas in simulation in local test, which is a great value for commissioning. As you can see, I can force an input and directly observe the outputs in the HMI. That's it. Now you know how to configure M251 DPAC I/O modules and faceplates.